Good evening, our Saviours, and welcome to Revelation Worship Facebook Edition. We really miss you here at church and can't wait to get back together with you. But in the meantime, we're going to worship God in the comforts of your own homes and the few of us that are here at church. Tonight, we're going to be listening to a message from Pastor Bruce. We're going to be singing some of our favorite songs, and we're going to be lighting the candles. So if you have a candle, I want you to go grab that and grab something to light it with and grab an adult to help you. And we're going to have a moment of silence before the prayer as you light the candle.
Let us pray. O Holy One, life giver, thank you for the precious gift of life we are blessed with today. We surrender to you all our fears and anxieties about tomorrow. Take them and remind us we can only live today and not in a future that hasn't yet arrived. Sustain us with your peace and open our hearts to the joys to be found this week as we live one day at a time. In the name of the risen Christ, we pray. Amen.
Amen. Let's sing Who You Say I Am.
Who am I that the highest King would welcome me? I was lost, but he brought me in. Oh, his love for me. Oh, his love for me. Who the sun sets free, oh, is free.
From Matthew chapter 6, Jesus says, Therefore, I tell you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat or what you will drink, or about your body, what you will wear. Is not life more than food and the body more than clothing? Look at the birds of the air. They neither sow nor reap nor gather into barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not of more value than they? And can any of you, by worrying, add a single hour to your span of life? And why do you worry about clothing? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. They neither toil nor spin. Yet I tell you, even Solomon in all his glory was not clothed like one of these. But if God so clothes the grass of the field, which is alive today and tomorrow is thrown into the oven, will he not much more clothe you, you of little faith? Therefore do not worry, saying, what will we eat, or what will we drink, or what will we wear? For it is the Gentiles who strive for all these things, and indeed your heavenly Father knows that you need all these things. But strive first for the kingdom of God and God's righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well. So do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will bring worries of its own. Today's trouble is enough for today. Let us pray. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of all our hearts be acceptable now in your sight, O God, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. Welcome to Revelation Worship, I believe the second to the last of the season. And I've entitled my shortened message here, One Day, One Week at a Time. Again, from Matthew chapter 6, verse 34, Jesus says, so do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will bring worries of its own. Today's trouble is enough for today. I don't believe God sent this coronavirus as some kind of plague upon our world. Something that causes so much sickness, suffering, including economic suffering and death, is not something that is heaven sent. That's a bad theology. But I do believe there will be many things that we can learn from this pandemic. Of course, that doesn't necessarily mean we will learn those things, but theoretically, we can learn them. One of those things may be a better appreciation of what it means to live one day at a time and one week at a time. I mean, really, what else can we do? Last week, you know, we all want to know how long this pandemic will last, right? Last week, my 7-year-old granddaughter in Milwaukee said, I want my normal life back. That's right, Lucy. We all want our normal life back, don't we? We want to gather again with extended family. We want to hang out with our friends, get back to our jobs, get back to school, worship in person, dine in at restaurants, go to movies, attend sports events. We miss all those things. We want to have things to look forward to at a time that we can count on. We need to have things to look forward to. I know that I do. What each of us looks forward to is different depending on our personality, depending upon our age, our stage in life, and the times in which we live. I remember when I was in junior high, we don't call it junior high anymore, for me it was 7th, 8th, and 9th grade, I was part of a big Boy Scout troop that went camping a lot. We would often go on a camp out, that was Friday afternoon to Sunday afternoon, every other month, and I looked forward to each one. Being away from home, having outdoor adventures with my friends, I mean, I loved it. I'd no sooner get back from one camp out on a Sunday afternoon than I'd start looking forward to the next one, which was already on my calendar. Having those campouts to look forward to was a big thing for me at that age. What do you most look forward to in normal times? And what are you especially looking forward to on the other side of this pandemic? Or at least when you don't have to stay home quite so much and you can start gathering more with others at a relatively safe distance. Unfortunately, as most of us realize now, there is no shortcut through this pandemic, is there? Last week, we heard some good news, a bit of good news here in Minnesota, that there may be enough tests available now so that those who think they might be infected can actually know. We still need this testing for antibodies to know how many have been infected, and I heard one expert say, actually, we may not have enough of the population that's been infected for those kind of tests to even be accurate yet. If there's a vaccine, it will probably not be for a long time. So much is still being learned about this virus. Drugs for treatment are still being experimented with. Some are saying it may be 12 or even more like 18 months to get through this to where we're at a place that's more normal, quote unquote, once again. And even as our economy begins to gradually open up, what exactly will that look like? And if there are future spikes in infection and hospitalization rates, will new stay-at-home directives be implemented? None of us can know. None of us can live into the future. The truth is, there's so much we don't know, can't answer, and can't predict. And all this uncertainty is really hard to live with. We can speculate. We can make educated guesses. We can listen to what experts are learning and telling us. But the only way to get through this is literally to live one day at a time and one week at a time. And maybe that's not such a bad thing to learn. What do you think? Life is a gift. It's a precious gift. We are given today, and we never really know about tomorrow. Jesus says not to worry about tomorrow because we have enough to deal with today. But for me and you to not borrow worry from tomorrow and to live one day at a time is extremely hard for us. We can't do it alone. We need God's grace to live this way, grace that comes through the help and support of each other, grace that comes through the strength and the peace we can receive through prayer and worship in Scripture. Psalm 118, verse 24 says this, "This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it." Today is the day we are given. What does it mean for me and you to live fully present in this day? How can we make the most of this time? Amidst all the anxiety of what's unknown about tomorrow, what joy might God bless me and you with today, this week? Let us rejoice and be glad in today. Amen.
Thanks, Pastor Bruce, for that awesome message. When we are physically together for worship, we give our offerings to the Lord. And during this time, we know that some people have lost their jobs or had their hours cut back, and we don't expect you to give if that has been the case. But if you haven't had that difficulty, and if you're able to give, please know that we need and appreciate your offerings as we continue to do ministry and reach out in new and different ways. You can mail in a check, or go to the Giving tab on our website, or you can text GIVE, G-I-V-E, to 763-317-0750. And that can be uppercase or lowercase letters. It doesn't matter. It works. So let's sing our last song, Oceans.
receive a blessing. During this stay-at-home time, may the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen.
Amen.
See you next week.
Bye.
Bye. We miss you.
You can go.
Oh, you were good.
I was so good, but then it happened. Standing is hard. Thanks, Pastor Bruce, for that awesome message.
Can't take you anywhere.
Who am I that the highest King would welcome me? I was lost, but he brought me in. Oh, his love for me.